Donald Trump and Dr. Fauci have not always seen eye to eye. I think that's very fair to say. And it's a little bizarre that a few weeks before an election, Donald Trump would continue to press and go after Dr. Fauci. Well, President Trump turned on Dr. Fauci yesterday, telling campaign staffers that people are tired of hearing from the doctor about the coronavirus and calling him a disaster. The president referred to Fauci as one of these idiots who got key aspects of COVID wrong. Let me backtrack a little bit, though, and let me start with a rally that Donald Trump held in Carson City on Sunday. And in this part of the speech, I don't know if it was off the cuff. It probably was. You could use this audio. You can make the argument and use this audio if you're in the Joe Biden campaign against Donald Trump. It's unbelievable. Have a listen to what Donald Trump did in mocking Joe Biden, and it has something to do with scientists. Have a listen to this.
If you vote for Biden, he will surrender your jobs to China. He will surrender your future to the virus. He's going to lock down. This guy wants to lock down. He'll listen to the scientists. If I listened totally to the scientists, we would right now have a country that would be in a massive depression. Instead of, we're like a rocket ship. Take a look at the numbers. And that's despite the fact that we have like five or six of these Democrats keeping their states closed because they're trying to hurt us on November 3rd. But the numbers are so good anyway. They'd be even better.
Okay, so that's a lie.
Do you take vitamins?
That's not a lie, Brian.
Okay, so if I can respond and say why it's a lie.
Well, you said that's a lie, and I'm saying it's not a lie.
Okay, so if I could respond and say why it's a lie. Okay. I never make statements like that on the show without facts to back it up. When you look at where the economy is right now, recently we had the worst quarter in economic history.
Well,
when
that's
you look
why it's a lie.
If I can please finish, because I'm still not done. Mm-hmm. If you could look at how many states in this country right now have an uptick in coronavirus cases, we had, I think, 750 people that died of the coronavirus yesterday alone. We are not in a rocket ship. If you want to talk about a rocket ship, we can talk about a rocket ship of coronavirus cases. Many doctors and scientists across the country are simply saying that we have the worst yet to come, even when it comes to this coronavirus.
Actually, Brian, the expectation is that the third quarter GDP numbers will be 33% annual growth, which would make it a little worse than the downside in quarter two.
So we can,
but that would be a rocket ship.
We can debate,
and if every single state was open like Florida right now, the unemployment would be near 5.5%.
Okay, so we
it
can
would be
debate
significantly
can,
lower. So he's correct that there are states right now that are keeping their states shut down, and it is suppressing employment.
So we've talked about this, which is
also hurting the economy. So he is totally correct in saying that.
JD,
and if you look at states like Illinois has some of the most strictest mask mandates in the country, and their cases are skyrocketing as well.
What states are completely shut down? What are you talking about?
Not completely. I know Stein's sending you something right now. Not completely shut down. But if they were open like Florida, if more states were open like Florida, more major states run by Democrats.
You just said states are completely shut down. That's
like
not true.
Like California, if they were open like Florida, the numbers would be significantly better. Unemployment.
I don't want to get into it.
And so with the economy.
Right,
well, I'm just saying you're wrong.
I'm not wrong.
And it's looking like the third quarter is going to be increased by an annual rate of 33% on the GDP.
You can have your opinions on what it's looking like. That doesn't mean it's going to happen, and that's not fact. The fact is there are no states that are shut down, but the fact also is that he is mocking Joe Biden for having trust in the scientist, which is an absurd comment to make. That's what we're talking about now. Make no mistake about it. He is mocking politicians, in this case Joe Biden, for trusting scientists. That is laughable, that is idiotic, and that is embarrassing. Now, Dr. Fauci appeared
on October 29th, in 10 days, we expect a report that says third quarter real GDP rebounded at a 33.4% annual rate. Well, you said that.
We just spoke about that. Now, why are you going back to it again?
That's my prognostication. No, that's from First Trust Portfolios in Chicago.
Okay, I never heard of First Trust Portfolios in Chicago. No, have no idea what that is or who they are, and quite frankly, I don't care. What I do care about is that we're close to a quarter of a million people that have died from this virus. And what I do know, and what I know for sure, is that we are at the epicenter of this virus, and we have been pretty much since day one.